CBC color presentation. Professional football brought to you by Labatt's, Brewers of 50 Ale, Canada's fastest growing ale, and Labatt's Blue, the true blue lager beer. The best in Canadian football from the best in Canadian beer.
The Ottawa Rough Riders are out to regain possession first place in the Eastern Conference, and the Montreal Alouettes are still desperately looking for their first win of the season. Good afternoon, everybody. This is Tom McKee. Welcome to CBC CFL Action. Our expert analyst on these broadcasts is the former star quarterback of the CFL, Bernie Filoni. And Bernie, I think, first of all, we should take a look at the last time that these two teams met when Montreal lost.
The trend of the last meeting between these two clubs was a blitz, and it's indicated here by 41, Peter Dumo, and Ron Everett putting a big rush on Jackson. And to counteract this blitz is one of three things: a trap, draw play, or a screen play. And Jackson comes back with a trap right up the center. And what's number 76 help 16 downfield? Roberts coming over and blocking, a great block for a 33-yard gain there by number 16, Mankins. Here's the rush again, and Jackson has to throw the ball, and it's wild. It's picked off by number 16, Phaneuf, of the Montreal Alouettes. It was a gambling type of a football game, and early in the first quarter, you'll see Wade throwing from the punting position just inches far from Murphy that would have given them possession of the football. This game was a seesaw back and forth and a hard-hitting type of a football game. And here's Wade working on the middle linebacker and throwing out to 23 Felt, working on number 41, and you'll see this later on, how Felt beats Ken Lehman for a touchdown. Back and forth, Jackson throwing to 27, Vic Washington for a fine reception and gain. As I said, this game was a hard-hitting type of football game, and seesaw back and forth, and there's plays like this one coming up to number 74, Peter Dallariva, beating 23 people for the touchdown. Look at this play. This is Don Southern attempting a field goal. It's wide, and Jim Walters in the end zone. Never really has possession of the football. Finally does get it. Runs it to around the 5-yard line. Is hit very hard. Fumbles. And Ron Stewart picks it up and runs into the end zone. There you see the touchdown. As we said, it was a hard-hitting type of football game, and it's going to be that way today. And here's Jerry Campbell picking on number 23, Phelps. And it's a good hit right under the chin. The ball's shaken loose and recovered by the Rough Riders in scoring territory. And we'll see the alert Jackson with a lot of time to throw this time, hitting Whit Tucker across the center. There you see Tucker and the score. And the play that we've been talking about, number 23 and beating number 41, Ken Lehman, is right now. And you'll see it's to the short side of the field. There's the pass. There's the touchdown, beating 41 in the end zone. As we mentioned and saw right there, that was a tough, hard-hitting football game. And Tom, I think today, the evidence of what we had just seen on those films, that it's going to be a real tough one again.
Bernie, both these clubs have come up with questionable plays or calls on third down situations late in the game, their last two games. What do you think about that as a former quarterback?
Well, it's...
Were they right or wrong?
They were wrong because... they lost the ball game in one instance and tied on the other. If they'd been right calls, they would have won in both ball games. However, pros and cons about it, you have to be able to make that guard at any time to be a professional football club, and Ottawa just wasn't able to do it, neither was Montreal.
And if it had worked, of course, there wouldn't have been any question at all. Thank you, Bernie. Our play-by-play commentator is Don Chevrier. And Don, do we have any lineup changes, first of all?
Well, one major change, Tom, the Alouettes of Dwight Lee, a new halfback in from the 49ers and Atlanta Falcons in the NFL. He played college ball at Michigan State. And so he will start with the benefit of only one day's practice behind him in the Montreal camp. He'll be number 32, Dwight Lee, worth watching today. Apart from that, Bobby Feltz being cut, no drastic changes for the Montreal Alouette Football Club. The Alouettes and the Ottawa Rough Riders are all set. We'll be ready with our national anthem and the opening kickoff after this message.
When you're smiling, say Labatt's Blue, the beer that smiles with you. It's the true one, good for you one, the lager that's true blue.
Next time,
just
say Labatt's Blue.
It's the lager.
Lager,
taste that is true. So when you're smiling, say Labatt's Blue. The true blue lager beer. So when you're smiling, say Labatt's Blue.
Whatever happened to those cool September days? It's about 80 degrees here in Ottawa as they get ready for the playing of our national anthem. From that big cannon at the other end of the field, the officials get set to get the game going, and they are Bill Dell, referee-in-chief, along with Gibbs Sagan, Seymour Wilson, John Chase, and Bud Wiley, rounding out the officiating staff this afternoon. Montreal Alouettes getting set to go on the left and receive the opening kickoff from Don Sutherland. Alouettes, only two ties in five CFL games. Ottawa has won four and lost one, that last loss against the Hamilton Tiger Cats on Monday. Story and Lee, Lee 32, Story 18 to receive the Ottawa kickoff. Story at the eight. Bob Story is back to the 15-yard line. A 7-yard return hit by Wayne Smith, number 60. And the Alouettes begin the game scrimmaging first down from their own 15. Alouettes is Sonny Way, the most exciting and promising quarterback, number 14. Gary Lefebvre from the Edmonton Eskimos is their flanker back, along with Tom Cassis. And the running backs are Dennis Duncan, 35, and Dwight Lee, 32. Duncan has 4 yards of the 19, met by Marshall Shirk, 53. Ottawa's left defensive tackle, the Rough Rider front four, Billy Joe Booth, 65 at one defensive end, Dave Braggett's 55 at the other. Inside, Jim Kane, 52, and Marshall Shirk, 53. The front four for the Rough Riders. Campbell, Lehman, and Giardino are the linebackers. He beat Billy Cooper, who's in the defensive backfield today despite a hamstring injury, and he moves the ball for a Montreal first down. 23 yards is the gain. Duncan, after a fake to Dwight Lee, surrounded by Jerry Campbell, 54, and Shirk, 53, and he will lose 2.5 on the play, back inside the Montreal 40. He'll be second and say 12 from there. 17-15, the score of the last game in favor of Ottawa in Montreal, 47-15 for the Rough Riders in the home opener last month. Pass interception.
Sonny Wade had plenty of time to throw this football, and he just couldn't find the receiver. It was a spread type of an offense. Don Sutherland hanging out in the flat, picks the ball off. Interception. The ball is thrown right to him, Don.
You see number 20, the intended receiver, Cassis, coming up from behind to make the tackle. He was badly underthrown. 10 yards to return by Sutherland. First down, Ottawa, the Montreal 48. Jim Mankins rolling across the 45-yard line. They mark him at the 44.
That's a record for Sutherland. He has 47 interceptions. The previous record was 46, held by Oscar Kruger of Edmonton and Toronto's Ed Learn.
By Larry Fairholme, 19, at the 30-yard line, and Ottawa first down. Rough Riders have looked less than sharp in their last two games, the squeaker against Montreal at the Autostad and the loss in Hamilton Monday, but before their home crowd here this afternoon, they look to be the explosive machine of old. Stewart. Put out, forcing Stewart out of bounds at the 3-yard line.
Now that was an option play of old, allowing Ron Stewart to get outside, but Russ Jackson made that play by holding that ball long enough and drawing Johnny Baker, number 77, into him before he pitched it out.
They placed the ball at the 4, the gain is 26 yards, and the Rough Riders are first down and touchdown to go. With the score.
That was the speed of Vic Washington that really made that touchdown. He just got outside and outran the defender. So you see here, he takes the handoff from Jackson and breaks back deeply. Some good blocking in there by Mankin, 16, but it was the speed of number 27, Vic Washington, that scored that touchdown.
Al Sutherland with the point after attempt. Rough Riders go in front 7-0, moving from the Montreal 48-yard line after Don Sutherland's pass interception gave them the football for the first time in the game. At a 4-minute mark of the first quarter of the score is Ottawa 7, Montreal nothing.
Taste of Labatt's Blue is winning more and more new friends all across Canada. Make friends with Labatt's Blue yourself. It's a good friend to have, a true blue friend.
So when you're smiling, just say Labatt's Blue, the true blue lager beer.
Blue, 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 Labatt's Blue.
The game less than 4 minutes old. The Rough Riders have the lead, 7-0. Southern gets set to kick off again. Story and Lee back to receive. Story at the eight. Back to the 21-yard line. Usually the Alouettes, Dennis Duncan, their power-running fullback, back on kickoff returns, but they've gone with Bob Story as part of their game plan, along with the new back, Dwight Lee. Barry Ardern and Doug Speck, the tacklers that time. The return was 13 yards, and from the 21, Montreal is first down as Cassis comes right, Lefebvre to the left. Dwight Lee in his debut across the 25-yard line near the 28. Van Berkley, the Riders' backup quarterback, punter and defensive halfback, and Billy Joe Booth, the defensive end with the tackles. The gain is 7 yards, second and three from the 28. Incomplete. Poirier, 17, bumped with him across the 35-yard line. Giardino had a chance for the interception, but couldn't bring it in.
The Rough Riders, whenever they get up close to the line of scrimmage, their defensive halfbacks are uptight. It's definitely a blitz situation, and they play a man for man. Other than that, they stay back in that 4-3 defense, and it's a zone defense all the way.
On third and three, Sonny Wade is the punter. Ardern at the 35. Slips him and is downed at the 38-yard line by Don Murphy. 7-0. The Ottawa Rough Riders, they scored the first time they got the ball. This is the second occasion. They'll move a series from scrimmage at the 38. That last punt by Sonny Wade carried 47 yards. Wind factor about 15 miles an hour out of the west. That means the Rough Riders have whatever wind advantage there is in this first quarter. Larry Fairholm has Vic Washington at the 46-yard line, and it's an Ottawa first down. The gain was 25 yards. Washington was bottled up in the games with both Montreal and Hamilton. In fact, in the Hamilton game, he gained only 10 yards, 4 rushing and 6 on pass receptions. But today, they've been able to spring him loose to become the threat he always has been to defenses across the CFL. Jim Mankins at the 40-yard line has 6, and they'll be second and 4 coming up. Mike Webster, 67, with the tackle for the Montreal Alouettes. Mankins, of course, is not the type of running back that Bull Scott was, but he certainly has the blocking ability, along with Ronnie Stewart, to make that explosive Ottawa offense go. Atkins dropped the ball with Matt James applying coverage number 21. So the Riders now run to third down and four from just across the 40-yard line of Montreal. Fairholme going back into the end zone with Story. They anticipate the field goal attempt from Don Southern. Jackson holding angle left at the 47-yard line. He topped the ball to Fairholme. Fairholme is back to the 6-yard line. Tom Pullen, 71, to stop him there. And with about the fourth quarter midway through now, and the Rough Riders in the lead 7-0, the Alouettes start from deep field position at their own 6-yard line.
Don Southern topping that ball reminds us that at halftime today, we're going to have a feature using slow motion, super slow motion cameras. One of them is on Don Southern. How he kicks those field goals and placement kicks. It's very interesting. Just like a golf shot, he says.
You gotta keep your head down. It's Dennis Duncan near the 10-yard line. Jerry Campbell and Ken Lehman meeting him there. Second and six to come for the Montreal Alouettes near their own 10. Campbell's 54, Southern 14. Billy Cooper in that defensive backfield again, number 23, and Booth 65. Alouettes center 45, Basil Bark. They send Starr with Lefebvre to the left. Gene Gaines back to the 15-yard line. The pass intended for rookie halfback Dwight Lee.
And there's Dwight Lee jumping for the ball. The ball is tipped around, and number 22, Gene Gaines, comes up with it, and it puts the Rough Riders in excellent position for scoring. It's a break, Don.
A big one at the 16-yard line. That is the second pass interception made by the Riders. One by Southern, now one by Gaines. First down. Number 27 blew right by number 12, Jack Lentz, for the score.
There was a good fake in the backfield there. And watch number 11. We may not see it as he blocks Peter Dumeau out there to enable Jackson to throw that ball to 27 Washington. Washington just outran him again.
Southern's convert makes it 14-0. So two pass interceptions by the Rider deep backs lead to two touchdowns, and a two-touchdown lead for the Rough Riders here at home at Lansdowne Park. 6:22, the time to play in the first quarter. The Rough Riders need a win to vault ahead of Hamilton into first place in a tremendously tight Eastern Conference race. They have 8 points now with Toronto, and Hamilton has 9, unbeaten with 4 wins and 1 tie. The Alouettes, 3 defeats and 2 ties. And there are 5 games prior to today. Now Dwight Lee is going back, along with Dennis Duncan. They've made that change, and Story is a shallow man at the 25-yard line. Thank you. Dwight Lee at the three. He bumped his own blocker. Harry Randall, number 55, and got back to the 22-yard line on an 18-yard return. Terry Black, younger brother of Rick Black, made the tackle for Ottawa. And again, the Alouettes start deep at their end of the field for the first down.
This is one of three games scheduled today in the CFL. Later this afternoon, Calgary plays at Edmonton and Winnipeg against the British Columbia Lions in Vancouver.
Cassis out to the right, 23 Cooper covering him. LaFave, number 10, almost had the reception of 22 Gene Gaines, nearly the interception.
Number 10, LaFave just ran straight down the field, and Sonny Wade lobbed the ball high in the air. That was almost an interception down there. But let's take a look at this and watch the defensive coverage and how that ball is just about knocked around and intercepted. LaFave almost had it. It was good play by the defensive halfbacks and LaFave also.
Second and 10 at the 22. Dennis Duncan at the 27-yard line will have a gain of 5, but not the Montreal first down. Ken Lehman, 41, drifting over to cover on the play for Ottawa defensively. Alouette's best field position today was their own 42 on the first series before Southern's interception. They've been stalled repeatedly by the Rough Riders, who send back their punt return team near the 45-yard line. Barry Ardern. Good run back across the 50 at the 52 of Ottawa. Don Murphy, 33, tackled him there.
This is the third time these two clubs have met this season. In the first game of the season, it was Ottawa 47, Montreal 15. And of course, that 17-15 win for Ottawa. And if it keeps going like this, we could conceivably end up with another 47-15. 64-30, the total score of those first two games.
Don Murphy, number 33, on one knee there, receiving attention from the Alouette training staff after the tackle on Barry Ardern. Kay Dalton, he says his job is on the line every time his team plays. It may not quite be that way, but Dalton certainly knows the pressure of winning. Necessity to get some wins and get some people into the autostat in Montreal. The crowds are on the upswing every game in Montreal. A couple of wins might just fill it. Jackson's down. Out of the blitz. Olszewski, 51, the middle linebacker, led the charge against him. Throw him back to the 41-yard line.
The coaches around the league say the only way you can beat Ottawa and Russ Jackson is put the blitz on him. And it's evident there that when they do come on with the full blitz and Jackson isn't ready for it, it's pretty tough, and I don't care who you are, to throw that ball.
Yardage of 11 lost on the play. Second and 21 now. Those deep backs scatter back now, expecting Jackson to throw.
Right here,
coming
right at you.
He counters with the draw to Jim Mankins at center field. Jack Lentz, 12, the tackler for Montreal. But they do not have the first down. They are short by 8. Good call by Jackson under the circumstances. Fairholm set to receive. He's the only deep back for Van Berkelio's kick. Hey, Roberts caught him by the sweater and threw him down to the 10-yard line after a 53-yard punt. by Van Berkelio.
That was quite a pontoon. He'll also be featured on our Super Slow Motion featurette at halftime, and he has some rather surprising statistics and ideas on the science of kicking that football. It's not all it looks, not quite as easy as it looks.
About 3.5 minutes to play in the first quarter. 14-0, Ottawa leads. Montreal from the 10, first down. Cassis, number 20, breaks right. Lefebvre, 10, to the left. Dwight Lee at the 15-yard line has about five, met by Marshall Shirk and Ken Lehman.
Ken Lehman, number 41 out there, playing that linebacker spot, just jumped right in the hole there. There was no way for him to get through.
At the 12-minute mark, then, of the first quarter, the score is Ottawa 14, Montreal nothing.
From Labatt's, the longest, coolest, most enjoyable refreshment that ever bent your elbow. No wonder Labatt's 50 is Canada's one and only enjoyment aid.
Enjoy yourself. Take 5 for 50 ale. Enjoy yourself. 3 5 for 50 ale. Labatt has brewed 50 just for you.
Frank Clair and Russ Jackson, a combination that has excited Ottawa football fans over the year, but one that may not last too long, as Russ says he definitely will retire after this 1969 season. Dwight Lee to the 34-yard line, hit by Gaines and Southern, and he shows promise, Bernie, as a potentially explosive back for the Alouettes.
He has great speed down there, Don, and we haven't seen him do too much, but on that particular play, he did show that when he got through the line of scrimmage, he could dance around a bit, and let's see what happens through the whole ball game.
The gain was 19 yards. Duncan lost the ball, and the Ottawa Rough Riders have it. Jim Kane, 52, as we see in the replay.
Here comes in a slow-mo. Jim Kane, almost simultaneously, when Dennis steps up, comes right by number 58, and the ball is knocked loose.
The third break the Ottawa Rough Riders have forced in this game. They've scored on two previous pass interceptions. Now, late in the quarter, their first down at the Montreal 32. With Tucker at the 17-yard line, hit by Nate James. The gain is 15 yards, and James a little slow to get up, but he's all right. Dalton was saying last night that you can plan all you want, but when it comes right down to it, it's your personnel against their personnel, and mistakes have to be made covering this Ottawa team. Dalton says he'll be happy once this game is over. It'll mean they've played the Riders three times and won't see them again on the regular schedule. Atkins overthrown by Russ Jackson.
That was a play that's used quite often with a speedster like Atkins. That's called a breakout and up or a down, out, and up. And he was in there all by himself, but the ball was thrown just a little too far.
And sort of the second pass Jackson has failed to connect on. He's 4 for 6 this afternoon. 1:18 to play in the first quarter. The Alouettes juggle defensively now on the second and 10. Whit Tucker couldn't bring it down to the 7-yard line. He was hit by Tom Cassis as the Alouettes send in Cassis and a number of others to shore up against an expected pass. And so it's third down at 10 from the 17-yard line. Southern's field goal attempt from the 24. And he has it. So the Riders run their lead on two converted touchdowns and on Southern's field goal to 17-0 over the Montreal Alouettes. With less than a minute left now, 48 seconds on the clock in the first quarter at Lansdowne Park. And for a team that wants to win so badly, Bernie, that's a tough way to start for Montreal.
They've been in trouble all through the first quarter, Don. They haven't been able to get out of their own end of the field only by punting.
Cassis, 20, comes out to the right with Lefebvre. Southern covering with Cooper. At the Ottawa 49, Tom Cassis has the catch and a Montreal first down.
That's a weakness of that zone defense. When number 14 Don Southern plays short, then you can run in between that gaping hole in there, and that's exactly where number 20 was, Cassis, when he caught that ball.
36-yard advance for the Ottawa 49. Marker thrown as the play unraveled. Jerry Campbell, number 54, in to break it up.
Campbell saw that play coming a mile away. It was offside, and that's why he got in the backfield. He got there just about the time that the ball was handed off.
That's bound to give him a little edge, all right, and it's been noted by the officials. The walk-off will be 5. Back to the 44. From where the Alouettes will have first down repeated and 5 yards to go. This could be the last play of the quarter. The clock ticking down to 2 seconds, now 1, and now no time at all. Dennis Duncan caught short of the first down at the 41-yard line. Met there by Gene Gaines, and at the end of the first quarter, the score is Ottawa 17, Montreal nothing. We'll return with more CFL action after this message.
Enjoy yourself, move with the 50 crew. Enjoy yourself, take 50 air with you. It makes no difference where you are or how you make your fun, so long as there's a 50 by Labatt's for everyone.
Only a 50 tastes as good as a 50, and you'll find 50 drinkers almost anywhere you care to look. They're Canada's enjoyment people, and most of all, they enjoy Labatt's 50.
Enjoy yourself, the 50 lamp is bright. Enjoy yourself, big 50's on tonight. Come join the crew, the growing 50 crowd. A better sound, regale yourself, requite yourself tonight, yourself. Enjoy yourself.
Two touchdowns by Vic Washington and a 24-yard field goal by Don Southern. Converted both times, the touchdowns by Southern are giving the Rough Riders a 17-0 lead as we get set to start quarter two. The Alouettes making their best move of the day at the 41-yard line are second and 2.5 for a first down. Ottawa's total offense in the first quarter, 113 yards against 88 for the Alouettes.
Second and two.
Dennis Duncan has the first down with room to spare at the 36. Hit by Ken Lehman. Got a just starting quarter two at Lansdowne Park. Muggy afternoon, temperature in the low 80s. Escape at the last moment by Sonny Wade to Dennis Duncan. He was rocked by Joe Poirier, 17, at the 26-yard line. And again, the Montreal Alouettes move close to first down range.
That's why they say that this number 14, Sonny Wade, is going to be a good one, Don, is because he doesn't panic. He stays in there. He stands tall. He's a big boy. And on that particular play, he was rushed, and he couldn't find the receiver downfield. As they said, he didn't panic and just dumped a little dump pass out there. They're very close to first down.
They're just that much short. As you can see, the ball not quite reaching the marker. Wade appears to be wearing blinkers, or if he hasn't got them on, he doesn't really care who's coming at him or from which direction. Certainly for a rookie pro quarterback, he has tremendous poise to stand in there against the rush. And that Ottawa rush can be considerable. So they have only inches to go, just outside the Ottawa 26-yard line. Second down. Wade gambling on the deep pass to Lefebvre at the 5-yard line on second and inches. And the Ottawa Rough Rider defense, Bernie, wasn't entirely fooled by it.
Don, the pass was thrown a little bit behind Lefebvre. Actually, I thought that was an excellent call in that particular situation because normally you are supposed to be able to make that few inches on that third down, as happened in the past. Both these teams failed to do that in their last time out. But on that play, it was a good fake into the line by Duncan, and it was also Lefebvre was in the clear, but the ball was thrown behind him.
You may wonder why they're measuring again. It's not to see if they had a first down, of course, on the incomplete pass. It's just to make sure the ball is exactly where it had been before, because it's third and only inches to go. And here's the first gamble on third down. And Dennis Duncan wins it. Ken Lehman, 41, met him, but not before Duncan had rolled across the 25-yard line into first down country. A little different there, Bernie, gambling from the other guy's 25 as opposed to your own 25, as we saw last Monday in both Hamilton and in Montreal. And the gambles lost and were costly in terms of the outcome of the games.
And remember, you're 17 points down here.
Doug Collins now in for Jim Kane on the Ottawa defensive line. For Cassis, oh, just turned too late. He was well in behind Billy Cooper, Bernie, just a case of turning around a split second too late.
Tom Cassis had good moves down there that time, Don. He had Billy Cooper all tied up in knots, so to speak. And when he did break out, the ball was thrown, I thought, perfectly. It was thrown on time. It was just that little fraction off.
For Cassis again, well overthrown. Again, Cooper covering at the dead ball line. So they now run the third down at 10 from the Ottawa 25. They send in John Baker and the field goal team. Baker's attempt with Fairholme holding will come from the 32-yard line, and the angle is to the left. He does not have it, and it will roll for a single point. Baker's attempt was wide to the left. And so at the 3-minute mark of the second quarter, the score is Ottawa 17 and Montreal 1.
Greg Morris. You know, great shows don't just happen. They take a solid cast, fine technicians, writers, producers, and directors to make them. I've been fortunate to work for these past seasons with such a combination. That's why Mission Impossible has built such a large and devoted audience. If you haven't been a regular viewer, I think you've been missing something. Because television has been described by some as a vast wasteland. But it is shows such as ours that help build in that vast wasteland. Mission Impossible helps to fulfill dreams. Dreams of adventure and excitement. With stories of espionage and suspense. It fulfills dreams and it builds spirit. Join Peter Graves as the leader of our IMF force and me, Greg Morris, for Mission Impossible, Friday nights, where you see us first on the CBC television network.
From their own 35-yard line, the Alouettes marched in 10 plays, 50 yards, and came away with only a single point. Ottawa first down at their 25. Stewart. Caught by Nate James at the 35-yard line, and he will be close to a first down. Stewart seems to be the forgotten man this season in the Rough Rider backfield, but Bernie, with the keys being applied to Washington, likely we'll see more and more of Ronnie.
Well, I think you would, but I think the key thing right there to making that play go is that everybody's after Jackson when he comes out with that option, and he draws two or three people coming in there, and this allows Stewart to be open.
He missed the first down by about half a yard at the 34. And Jackson straight ahead has it near the 37. Rough Riders of a fine offensive line in front of a great backfield. Doug Stack is playing center now. Roger Frederick and Tom Schutte are the guards. Racine and Bainan are the tackles. Adkins and Jay Roberts are the ends. With Tucker, 26, the flanker moves right. Jim Mankins has nowhere to go at the 37-yard line. Held for little game. Webster and Everett, the two Montreal defensive tackles, there to meet him. It is 17-1 with about 5 minutes gone in the second quarter at Lansdowne Park. Ottawa on the heavy end of that score. Expecting the pass, the Alouettes make some changes, sending in Story, Cassis, and Murphy. Mankins back to Jackson. And he reaches the 50-yard line where he has the first down. Bernie, that's, along with the Statue of Liberty, one of football's oldest plays, but it still works.
Still works. Normally that play is called down in close down when you don't have to run so far for a touchdown. I think Jackson thought, well, he can go all the way with that ball. But let's look at that defense of the Montreal Alouettes in a passing situation. When they put in number 20, Cassis and Murphy, they go into what they call an umbrella defense. It's a 4-3 type of a defense, but don't let anybody get behind you.
Right through Whit Tucker's hands with Al Phaneuf covering at center field. The last strike back to Jackson from Mankins gained 19 yards, and so now it is second down and still 10 from the Ottawa 50.
Come on, Peter.
Jackson flipping out to Jim Mankins, and the gain is very small, perhaps a yard or two at the 51. It's a one-yard gain. Larry Fairholm, 19, getting up slowly after tackling Mankins. Well, the Alouettes have held the Rough Riders on two plays, and they'll be third down as Fairholm, under a little difficulty, heads for the Montreal bench. Third down and 9. And Berkeley is set to kick to Woodward and Story. Woodward in for Fairholm. Woodward back inside his 10, lets Story pick it up, and he is dropped right there. Roger Perdriks with the tackle. 51-yard punt, mainly on a good roll, but hit the ground. So again, the Montreal Alouettes have poor field position back at their own 10.
If Ottawa go on to win this game, that'll give them 10 points for the season and drop them into first place in the Eastern Conference. Hamilton will be next with 9 and Toronto in third place with 8. But, of course, don't forget Toronto has that big game coming up tomorrow afternoon at the CNE Stadium in Toronto against the Saskatchewan Rough Riders. And a win there could bring them back into a tie with Ottawa.
We're told that's just about a complete sellout, too, at CNE Stadium tomorrow afternoon. Dennis Duncan drives across the 15 near the 18-yard line where Jerry Campbell is in a wrestling match with him, along with number 55, Dave Braggins. May seem a little hard to believe in view of the score, but Ottawa has scored on explosive-type plays, which is their trademark. The Alouettes have run 23 plays from scrimmage so far today, and the Rough Riders have run only 20 by comparison. But the big scoreboard edge goes to Ottawa, 17-1. Montreal, 2nd and 2 at the 18. Dwight Lee appears to be just short of the first down, very close at the 20, but the ball has to touch the 20-yard line to make it. As you see where they spotted down, it has not quite reached that far. Ken Lehman, 41, was there to contain him. And at the request of the offensive team, Montreal, the yardsticks come out. I guess a measurement, as it is a third down, gives the team time, Bernie, to think over whether to gamble or not, but it does not appear to be the case that they're going on this one.
The gamble, Don, depends on how far you have to go, and really you don't have too much time to think. The coach will tell you what to do.
It's never a gamble if you make it.
In retrospect, it never is. No. Good high kick from Wade. Cooper inside his 30. Tagged by De La Riva, finally dropped at the 33-yard line by number 63, Pierre Desjardins. A 57-yard kick in the air all the way from Sonny Wade. So the Rough Riders start out from their 33 with the first down. The clock showing 6 minutes and 58 seconds of first half play remaining. 17-1 the score with Ottawa leading. Don't forget our feature in super slow motion at the half. Some of the outstanding stars of the Ottawa Rough Rider Football Club. Some moves you'd never see when they're going full speed. Washington shook off the first tackle from Pierre Dumont, then crossed the 35-yard line where Jack Lentz has him. The gain is only 4, but he had to do a lot of running to get it. Again, that Montreal pass for that defense comes in. They take out Dumont, number 41, number 64, Ron Everett, and number 30, Peter Howlett. Send in Story with Cassis and Murphy. They sacrifice rushing lineman for deep defensive backs. Number 12 has 12. 12 yards to the 50-yard line and a little beyond, and the Rough Riders move the yardsticks.
The Alouettes rushed only 3 men that time, and that's a very vulnerable situation when you have a quarterback who can run with the football. They are covering all the receivers and leaving themselves wide open up the center.
Whit Tucker goes wide left. Margene Atkins comes to the right with Washington in the slot.
All right, 27. Set, cut one.
Tucker inside the 50-yard line. Larry Fairhall, 19, finally caught up with him. Once again, it is an Ottawa Rough Rider first out. 11 yards was the advance. Fans here in Ottawa getting ready for a big home-and-home series coming up next couple of weekends against the Toronto Argonauts. In Ottawa next Saturday and back in Toronto the following Saturday, September 20th, and CBC Television will have both those games in full color for you. Right now, Frank Clair, even though he has a lead of 17-1, a little more preoccupied with beating the Montreal Alouettes.
Right down your throat. 21,
Stewie. Stewie. Dumas gets taken out. Matkins has the pass. Al Fanaf, number 16, applied the tackle. But it's another Ottawa first down and a gain of 18.
Russ Jackson isn't throwing that big long bomb in this game so far, Don. He's staying to a relatively short type of a pass offense, throwing little bend outs and deep hooks. But so far, the bomb has been absent. This is something that you would hardly believe that a seasoned quarterback would ever do. Although he has great competitive spirit, Jackson is bottled up here, and normally he would keep his hands on a ball, but he's trying to lob a hook shot for a completion. And Johnny Baker, number 77, comes up with a hot potato play, so to speak, and a big break for the Alouettes.
Baker turned out to be the basket. First down from the 25. Dennis Duncan caught on a good first tackle by Ken Lehman. Jackson is only 9 touchdown passes away from the all-time CFL leader, Sam Etcheverry, who threw 174. Jackson now has 165 career touchdown strikes. The gain for Duncan was 3 yards, and from the 28, the Alouettes will be out 2nd and 7. Less than 3 minutes to play now in the first half. Nowhere to go in that backfield for Dwight Lee. At a 12 and a half minute mark of the second quarter, the score is Ottawa 17, Montreal 1. An indicator of the wind here at Lansdowne Park this afternoon, about 15 miles an hour out of the west. Alouettes have it at their backs now as Wade gets set to punt on 3rd and 5. Cooper and Ardern to receive at the Ottawa 30 and 35. Ardern back to his own 40 or 39 yard line, hit hard by Don Murphy. On the play, it looks like Murphy lost the exchange. He stretched out at the 40-yard line. 48-yard punt.
Sonny Wade has been, his average going into this game for kicking was 42-3. So he's certainly above that. That's about the only bright spot that Montreal has had in this game so far. Now it looks like another cloud has come over.
It's Peter Paquette who is following up on the tackle, number 26, the injured Montreal player. There's Paquette, as you see on the replay, coming in from the side on Ardern. The first tackle made. And then the whole world comes right down on top of Peter Paquette. He is up now and making his way, as you see, to the Montreal Alouette bench. Two minutes and 31 seconds until halftime, and it's 17-1 for the Rough Riders over the Alouettes, with Ottawa getting set to go first down from their own 39. Fake to Mackin.
We talked about the absence of the bomb. Jackson rolls out to his left. He has quite a bit of time to throw this ball to Atkins. As you see, it's a transcontinental type of pattern. Back against the flow. Perfect pass, perfect reception, and what they call in football, because you score a perfect play.
And there's the bomb that we noted that was absent in the earlier part of this game. 70 yards for the touchdown as Sutherland attempts the extra point. And he puts it through for the third time today and runs the Ottawa Rough Riders lead over the Montreal Alouettes to 24-1. Just over 2 minutes to play in the first half. The longest completed pass this year in the CFL was 87 yards, Tom Wilkinson to Jim Thorpe in the Argonaut-Montreal game on August the 5th. That 70-yarder does not quite qualify as a record, but certainly excited the fans here at Lansdowne Park this afternoon and gave the Rough Riders their third touchdown. 18 Story and 32 Dwight Lee, the kickoff return team. They'll stand at about the five. Sutherland has not been booming them too deep today, not getting under the ball all the way. Story at the 10. Stripped at the 20-yard line and down at the 22 by Terry Black. The return was 12 yards. And the Alouettes start out with 2:11 on the clock. First down at their own 22-yard line. Then as Duncan veered back into a traffic jam on the right side, got across the 25 at the 27 for about five.
Good quarterbacking right at this particular point of the game. There's a minute and 45 seconds left to go. You're down 23 points. You have to throw the ball. You have to at least try to throw the ball and get a score on that scoreboard before this half.
By Sonny Wade, and it runs to third and five now for Montreal, back of their 27-yard line. 1:20 remaining until halftime. 24-1 the score, Ottawa leads. Wade to punt to Cooper and Ardern back at the Rough Rider 40. Billy Cooper is caught by a Murphy right at the 41. Wade Patriots kick that time, traveling 43 yards. Sonny Wade had one memorable punt this year. That was the longest punt of the season, 87 yards against Hamilton. Jackson into first down range at the 52.
That was an attempted screen pass, and the Alouettes sniffed it out pretty good, and Jackson picks up that yardage, running very well.
Mike Webster back at the 40-yard line, coming into picture range now, limping as he makes his way to the Montreal bench. Jackson has carried the ball three times for a total of 25 yards this afternoon. Gene Atkins with a one-handed attempt at the Montreal 40 can't bring it in, but there's a marker back at the line of scrimmage. The walk-off, as you see, against the Montreal Alouettes. It's the first penalty against Montreal today, and it is for rough play, 15 yards at the 43. 35 seconds remaining. The Rough Riders with time to score again here in the first half. Atkins broke a body check at the 35-yard line and then got inside the 25 where he's bumped out by Woodward.
That umbrella defense is keeping everybody in front, Don, but they're leaving a big gaping area in there for Jackson to complete those passes.
24 seconds left now, and the Rough Riders have first down at the 21. Woodward, 15, limps out, replaced by Tom Cassis, number 20. Jackson for Tucker. Touchdown.
John, you just can't give Russ Jackson that much time to throw the football. When he has time, he has receivers like Tucker, and he goes down and makes a breakout, and you just can't cover it. Three blockers out there, all the time in the world to throw the ball, and he finally gets Tucker running around in that pattern for the score.
He had Tucker open once before, didn't spot him, then Tucker came back to the corner and made good the second time around. So here's Sutherland's convert attempt. That's good. Sutherland's 4-for-4 in conversions today. And the score now, just before the half, 15 seconds left, is Ottawa 31 and the Montreal Alouettes 1. While the Rough Riders were favored by most quarters, between 14 and 16 points today, who would have thought they'd run up a lead of 30 points before the half? Kay Dalton, one of the more outspoken coaches in the CFL, certainly one of the most cooperative when it comes to pregame information, but one of the unluckiest in terms of battles with the Ottawa Rough Riders. And as we said before, Kay will be awfully happy to see the end of his three-game stand against the Rough Riders this afternoon. Ardern, the first man to meet Story, drops him at the 30-yard line. There's an indication of an infraction on the kickoff. We'll wait for it. The return was 20 yards. The Alouettes have the option. Ottawa Rough Riders indicated as being offside on the kickoff. The option being to take it or to force the Rough Riders to kick off again, and the Alouettes have chosen the latter. This time, Southern will kick from his own 35-yard line. 10 seconds remaining in the second quarter. 32, Lee back with the Story on the kickoff return team for Montreal. Dwight Lee. Matt at the 41-yard line, and the Owls will have time for likely one play from there. 16-yard kickoff return. Alouettes of a boy named Mike D'Amato, who played on the defensive backfield as a safety with the New York Jets the past 2 years, and while Lee is playing here with only one practice behind him, they simply couldn't get D'Amato ready in time. Kay Dalton's very high on him.
Last play! Good job!
The tight end, Bill Starr, caught in behind the line of scrimmage for a loss at the 35-yard line as play runs out in the second quarter. So the halftime score is Ottawa 31, Montreal 1. We'll return with our halftime show after this message.
To say that children like animals has got to be an understatement. Just visit a zoo and watch the faces of any of the youngsters there. You'll see a love for life as you have never seen. But children are like that. Their affections are deeply felt. Whether it's an animal or a bird in a zoo, a dog in the street or playing a game, their whole lives are made up of loving. And that is what is so important to our children's department at the CBC. We try to understand children and help them to keep on loving. We do it by making programs especially for them. Programs that are both fun and educational. Encourage your children to watch CBC Children's Show.
Tom McKee back at Civic Stadium in Ottawa. You know, football, like most sports, is a fast-moving game. Often things take place that simply cannot be seen by the human eye. So we used our super slow motion cameras to show some aspects of the play which might otherwise be missed. Things like passing and kicking, blocking, receiving. First, the pass receiver.
Margie Natkins likes to catch the ball high. This makes the job of the defensive back even more difficult. In this trap block, guard Roger Perdrick's job is to take out the opponent while the ball carrier follows his leading block very closely. Don Southern shows us pass defense. It requires good anticipation and perfect balance. He watches the receivers at all times. He must be able to turn, stop, start, turn, and stop again in split-second timing. In punting, Bill Van Berkelio prefers the toe of the ball down with the laces on the side so his kicking force hits a soft part of the ball instead of catching it on a seam. Therefore, his foot actually works like a slingshot. Again, Margene Atkins on a pass play. The big job for Atkins is to get around any defenders, then resume his practice pattern to be at the right spot at the right time. Don John Southern compares the kickoff to a golf shot. Watch as he keeps his head down. Don says this is necessary because otherwise, again like golf, a kicker can slice, hook, or top the ball. Concentration is the secret. Passing is an art often learned incorrectly, according to Bill Van Berkelio. Watch closely and you'll see the ball leave his hand with the fingers flicking to the outside, not down and in as you might otherwise suspect. This offers better control and more strength. Roger Perdrix shows the prime requirement in a pass block, proper balance. Watch his feet and his hands. There is no holding while blocking the opponent. A great asset for a pass receiver is to fake the defensive backfielders. You're watching these sequences at 1/20th of normal speed. In field goal kicking, Don Southern likes the laces away from him, prefers the holder to use his left hand, and again keeps his head down and keeps it there until the ball is actually through the goal posts.
Ottawa 31 and Montreal 1, and we'll continue with our halftime show after this message.
Keep Can-Air Relief flying. Every day, Can-Air Relief flies food and medicine to save lives in Biafra. Each flight feeds 200,000 people for one day. Can-Air Relief is doing something to reduce the threat of starvation in Biafra. You can help. Keep Can-Air Relief flying. Send your contribution to Can-Air Relief, Box 334K, Toronto.
Canadian Professional Football. This portion brought to you by the Canadian Broadcasting Corporation for the best in television sports coverage across Canada every season.
This is the CBC Television Network.
Canadian Professional Football. This portion brought to you by
Canadian Pacific. Serving you in so many ways.
When you first check the statistics of the first half of today's game, it doesn't look as if there should be a 30-point discrepancy between these two clubs. That is, until you get down to the passing yardage. And most of that for Ottawa has been picked up by four catches by Margene Atkins, 124, and of course the big one of 70 yards going for the touchdown. On rushing,
Montreal has pretty well been out of it. They've picked up only a total of about 60 yards, maybe 70. Lee and Duncan doing most of the work, and Duncan not having a good day at all, 10 for 29. But the real story is over here on pass interceptions, and those two big ones for Ottawa that both went for eventual touchdowns, and both of those touchdowns scored by Vic Washington. Montreal has picked off one interception deep in their own zone, and they couldn't capitalize on it. The score, Ottawa 31 and Montreal 1. We'll continue with our halftime show after this message.
These bring back memories. But you know, I never did see a bullfight. You wouldn't go. Now, Mexico will always be that midnight swim at Puerto Vallarta.
Oh, yes.
And we didn't see one pair of wooden shoes in Amsterdam. But that trip down the Rhine made up for it. Australia. Now, that was a great trip. You kept trying to ride that surfboard, remember? On a stopover in Hawaii. I missed my bullfight in Spain, too. But remember the flamenco dances? Now, darling, would you like a tea house or an elephant?
Mm-hmm.
I called CP Air today. Booked us to Tokyo and Bangkok.
Travel with CP Air is a global affair. CP Air, another way Canadian Pacific serves you.
It must be obvious that it's hot and humid here in Ottawa, and it must be obvious to the Montreal Alouettes, too, as they have been up against quite a bit of heat and heavy pressure from the Ottawa Rough Riders. Bernie, did you really think it would be this bad as we take a look at these highlights?
I thought it'd be a lot closer than this, yeah. But the thing that's been happening is interceptions and fumbles and breaks by the Ottawa Rough Riders. And here's the first one with Don Southern intercepting, and Sonny Wade has time to throw, but he gets a little panicked there, it looks like, and he throws short. Don Southern in a short flat, and number 14 makes a fine interception there. And this leads to that first touchdown by Vic Washington. Washington, with his great speed, is the guy that he dips in and dips out and just runs around the end for a touchdown.
Yeah, there's been some suggestion that he's been hesitating lately. Well, of course, he had to hesitate on that play, back off a little bit on a couple of steps, but there was no hesitation as he crossed the line.
None whatsoever. Then here comes the second break. Sonny Wade again throwing, and this ball is intended for the newcomer, Dwight Lee. It's bounced around. And number 22, Gene Gaines, comes up with a key interception again early in that first quarter. And guess what?
Yeah.
Number 27 again. And this time on a pass play, number 11, Ronnie Stewart, makes the key block here on number 41, Pierre Dumont, to give Jackson time to throw the ball. And Vic Washington, again with his great speed and breakout power, is all by himself out there in the flat. Here's a big one, 70 yards. Jackson has a lot of time. He throws back against the flow on a perfect pattern. This is what we mentioned earlier as the perfect football play, because it ended up in a score and the ball was thrown perfectly. The blocking was perfect. It was just one of those great plays. And don't give this guy too much time. Number 12, Jackson, with three blockers in front of him, finds 26 on a breakout just at the flag, right on the corner for the touchdown.
Bernie, have you noticed that Sonny Wade seems to be taking almost too long in there? Can that be possible?
Well, he probably is having a little trouble finding his receivers, Tom. And he looked like he was a little bit panicky in there. He should be throwing that ball within 3 seconds, really. And unless you have a seasoned professional quarterback like Russ Jackson that looks around and finds the guy he wants and then throws it to him.
He also seems to be pumping. Does this give anything away?
Not really. The pumping, we happen to have a football here, so
yeah,
let's talk about that.
I guess
that.
You've thrown a good many of these. Eh?
There are quite a few of them. Tom, Jackson, let's talk about Jackson
right.
Doing that football. And if I can just show you Jackson's grip on the ball, I was talking, his hands are a little bit bigger than mine, but he likes to have two fingers on the laces. And when Jackson comes back, you'll notice he does pump always once with the ball, but he brings it up here tight, close to his ear, and when he throws, he releases the ball, he releases it so that it goes off on the fingers, such as here. We'll show it this way. And then his follow-through with the wrist snap is down. Bill Van Bertriel, his wrist is out that way.
Yeah, he flicks his fingers out. I wonder how you're going to throw the ball, though, when you've got those big linemen coming in at you. There's a blitz or something. Can you compensate for that?
The only compensation is don't close your eyes and throw the ball quick.
Yeah, that's about it. Okay, Bernie, thank you very much. And the score here at halftime, Ottawa 31 and Montreal Alouettes 1. And we'll return with the second half kickoff
in just a moment.
When it comes to looking after the pies that Mother makes, Joe Mooney is a real fuss budget. He cares so much about Mother's pies that he looks after each one himself. And when he has to send a shipment to a customer, he makes sure nothing can go wrong. He uses CP Ship's containers, of course. He knows there's no better way to ship Mother's pies, because the cargo stays in the container, and the container stays unopened. The only thing that gets handled is the container itself. So when it gets to his customer, it will be just the way Joe packed it. And Joe, he's so relaxed, he can take Mother Mooney off on a White Empress vacation cruise. For a fuss budget like Joe, that says a lot about our containers. CP Ships, another way Canadian Pacific serves you.
Don Chevrier with Bernie Filoni, Tom McKee, our spotter Art Darch, and statistician Ron Andrews at Lansdowne Park, the Civic Center complex in Ottawa, where we're set to resume play in a moment in the second half. And the Rough Riders lead 31-1 in a surprising show of strength. Not surprising, really, for the Rough Riders as a team, but in view of their last two games when both the Montreal and the Hamilton defenses contained Ottawa better than anyone had previously in 1969. But those easy days are all over because the Rough Riders, scoring 31 points in that first half, have displayed again. They are not in a slump, not about to decline as a power in the CFL Eastern Conference. But this race is extremely tight, as you know. The Rough Riders hoping to get into first place and well on their way today over the Hamilton Tiger Cats and the Toronto Argonauts. The Argonauts tomorrow play Saskatchewan Rough Riders at CNE Stadium in Toronto. Then next Wednesday, in a game we'll televise from the Auto Stade in Montreal, the Saskatchewan team moves in against this Alouette club. The scoring, three touchdown passes by Russ Jackson, and then a four-yard dash by Vic Washington have accounted for the Ottawa TDs, and the field goal by Don Southern, who has 7 points in all on the field goal and four convert. And there's Carroll Williams, the original starting quarterback at the beginning of the season for Montreal, warming up now. Sonny Wade appears to have taken his job away, but the indication is Kay Dalton may make a change in the second half. Lee will come out of the game, and Carroll Williams, the 14th import, will be able to come in. Atkins, 73, and Vic Washington, of course, back for Baker's kick. Washington back to the 30-yard line and beyond. 24-yard kickoff return. Rough Riders first down, just outside their own 30.
Number 73, Oleo, they call him. Margene Atkins on the receiving end of a real long pass. The bomb again. The bomb has been absent in the first half except for one big one, which was 70-yard touchdown. And here again, opening up in the second half in the third quarter, Margene Atkins.
That was good, Bernie, for 57 yards. James and Fairholm finally wrestle him down at the 23 of the Alouettes. Jackson faked the extension out to Stewart and then hit the 15-yard line himself. Pierre Dumo, 41, the Alouette linebacker, with the tackle. And the gain is 7 yards. 7-8, they'll be second down, a little more than two to go.
Yeah.
defense right out of there. Vic Washington, with his speed and agility, is able to find the hole just outside the tackle, and he has help as he runs into the end zone.
Nate James of the Alouettes getting assistance now at the 10-yard line. Very groggy, as you can see. Washington running 15 yards for his second touchdown today, and so the ability to contain Vic Washington is on the way as well. It's the second touchdown running, and in the game is third overall, having taken a pass to Jackson in the first quarter, a 16-yarder.
Washington's average starting this game in rushing was 7.1, so he's well above that, that's for sure.
And Southern again on the conversion attempt. And Southern is 5 for 5. And the Rough Riders very early in this third quarter run it to 38-1 over the Montreal Alouettes. I don't imagine that either Joe Rustick in Hamilton or Leo Cahill in Toronto are enjoying what they see this afternoon in the way of Ottawa offense bring.
I think they're probably enjoying it by watching it, Don. They wouldn't have enjoyed it the other game against the Tiger Cats, I'm sure.
Southern getting set to kick off. Duncan, 35, and Story, 18. Story on the right. Return for Montreal. Story at the 5. At the 25, that's all. Gene Gaines, last man up, first man with the tackle. The return was 20 yards. Just into the second half, a minute and 45 seconds gone in the third quarter, and it's 38-1. The Ottawa Rough Riders, who ran up a 31-1 halftime lead, and are showing little mercy against the Alouettes in the second half. 10, Lefebvre out to the left, Cassis 20 is to the right, and there's Carroll Williams to quarterback the Elves, number 9. Star thrown out of bounds by 54 Jerry Campbell. Alouettes will be 2nd and 3. The advance was 7. 17 Poirier in the defensive backfield with Ardern. Giardino 21. 23 Billy Cooper. 22 Gene Gaines and 14 Don Southern. Duncan juggled the ball briefly, but couldn't find an opener. Like he will lose a yard on the play. Jerry Campbell again. Fine linebacker obtained from the Calgary Stampeders a couple of seasons back in the defense for Ottawa.
Don, the explosive offense has been talked about very much with the Ottawa Rough Riders, but let's look at their defense also. They've been playing very well and holding.
The defense minifigure give Ottawa the edge over Hamilton and Toronto. The stronger defensive team. While their offenses can all score, they figure the Rough Riders are the better defensive 12. Cooper away from Murphy and then caught by Bark and by Paquette inside the 35-yard line. He lost a couple of yards in that return, and from the 34, it will start out with a first down.
Vic Washington is, with his 3 touchdowns today, gives him a total of 42 points to put him in behind Don Southern, his teammate here in Ottawa, in third place in the Eastern Conference scoring. Of course, Nami Joe Coffey of Hamilton way in front there with a total of 70 points.
And Coffey with a good head start on breaking his existing CFL Eastern Conference scoring record. Cannot get away from the last man, Larry Fairholm, after a superb catch at the 30.
It's a swing pattern out of the backfield. Hit the speedster. Jackson has time, but this is not one of his better passes. The ball is just hanging up there, And Vic Washington makes a great effort to get this ball, but an equally great effort is number 19, Larry Fairholme, covering on the play. Larry was hurt earlier in the ball game, and the great professional that he is back in there playing.
He was all the Owls had to stop him, and he did the job. But 47 yards is the gain, and from the 29, it's another Ottawa first down. With Tucker and Woodward collide in the end zone. Tucker going under the ball, and they rule it was accidental. No pass interference. In fact, it was Tucker who ran into the defensive man.
Jackson's gambling down there. Of course, he can with 37-point lead, and he's just trying to get touchdowns for all his speedsters, I would imagine. But if he stayed with that short game like he was earlier at this point of the game, he would probably score a lot quicker.
I asked Russ yesterday if he was still definite about retiring, and he said, there's no way, Don, I'll come back. He said, the fella has to know when to quit this game, and I think I've chosen the right moment. Jackson lost the ball, but it's back in Ottawa possession. Tom Schutte, number 56, had it bounce right into his arms to make the fumble recovery.
That was a planned play. That was not a broken play. It's what is called a quarterback draw. Jackson goes back just a few steps into that pocket. When the hole opens up in the line, he jumps through.
All planned except for the fumble, I guess, Vern. First down it is. Jackson calling an outstanding game here this afternoon. The Alouettes only have total offense of 127 yards. At the 4-minute mark of the third quarter, the score is Ottawa 38, Montreal 1.
They say, build a better mousetrap, and the world will beat a path to your door. But they're wrong. Because just building that better mousetrap isn't enough. You're going to have to beat a path to the world. The marketplace. But that's something your average better mousetrap builder may need a little help with. Expert help. The kind you get from CP Rail. We don't just move goods. We move them to the right place at the right time. We'll even design special equipment if it will help you get to that new market in Canada or beyond.
So you build your better mousetrap, or your better anything else. We're ready to help you beat a path to the marketplace.
CP Rail, another way Canadian Pacific serves you.
Jackson on that fumble, you see on the threes there that he's carrying the ball loose, and he's just turned around and being hit, that arm is hit as he's being turned around, and the ball pops out backwards and was recovered by his teammate. You see the ball bouncing out.
Right on a straight line to shoot it. He didn't have to move an inch for it. First down, Ottawa. Roberts, the touchdown catch. Mentioned that they look to be going to give everybody a chance. Jay Roberts just received his opportunity and made good on it with his first touchdown.
Don, you have to keep the rush on. I think that Jackson has demoralized this Montreal club because they just can't get to him. And he has a lot of time to find the receiver, and there's Jay Roberts roaming around down just 2 yards in the end zone.
Sutherland adds his sixth convert of the afternoon, 6 for 6 on a field goal. The Rough Rider offense is in excess now of 450 yards net against 127 for the Montreal Alouettes. And the score is 45-1. We have 10 minutes and 21 seconds to play in the third quarter. Kay Dalton, most anxious man in the park, no doubt the most frustrated too by the inability of his defense to contain the Ottawa Rough Riders. Story is back with Dennis Duncan. Sutter had topped the ball. Story waits for it. Shortstop at a softball game there with the ball just hopping through his leg. He picked it up and got back over the 15-yard line where he's met by Ardern and Giardino. A 7-yard return once more. The Alouettes, hoping to get some semblance of offense going, have to start deep at their end of the field. Double strength right for Montreal. Handing off to Dennis Duncan across the 20-yard line. Doug Collins in for Jim Kane. A defensive tackle made the stop. 4-yard gain makes it 2nd and 6 to come for Montreal. Many changes now on the Ottawa defense. Specht is in for Shirk. Wayne Smith, number 60, is in for Billy Joe Booth as Frank Clair rests some of his regulars. Joe Poirier, of course, has gone most of the way in the defensive backfield with Barry Ardern. Fade to the 36-yard line, and the Bluebirds here at Lansdowne Park give a facetious cheer on the reception.
It's either facetious in the way of cheering, or it's some disgruntled Montreal fans who might have driven up for the day. Don.
First on call from Carroll Williams. Intended for LeFave, and in disbelief is number 20, Barry Ardern, that he couldn't bring it down. So it runs to 2nd down now for Montreal. Alouettes at home against Saskatchewan Rough Riders Wednesday at the Auto Stad. Tomorrow, Saskatchewan against Toronto at CNE Stadium. Again, they send two receivers to the right, Starr and Cassis. LeFave, 10, on the left side. Peter Dellariva in the clear, overthrow at the Ottawa 45-yard line, but a marker back at the other 40-yard line. Holding is the call against the Montreal Owls.
What else could go wrong for them today, Don?
When the wheels fall off, not easily replaced. Everything has gone wrong for Montreal, but Ottawa has made it so. They forced the play, taken it to them. And as you commented a while ago, the Alouettes appear to be totally demoralized at this state. Their defense probably asked to do too much by an offensive team that can't sustain the ball. Punt taken by Cooper at the 32. Ricks through a pocket, and then Bark has him at the 37-yard line. 7 minutes and 51 seconds remaining now, and here's Sonny Wade's punting spot.
Wade comes off the ground when he kicks that ball. He really puts a lot of follow-through and effort into it. That's how he gets that big height.
And there's the Ottawa putter, who is the man of the hour at quarterback, leaving Russ Jackson, giving him a rest, Billy Van Berkelio.
He could be warming up for next season.
Number 15 throws the ball to Vic Washington on his first play in, and Washington, the great runner that he is, but what's number 73, Margene Atkins, blocking out there for him. And I believe that Washington, with his speed, if it was the outside, if he stayed outside, he might have gone all the way.
They moved it 37 yards in that play. Harry Black into the offensive backfield for the first time today. Hit by Harry Olszewski. Black lost a couple. He lost the better part of 3 yards. Russ Jackson showing a rest at the Rough Rider bench.
Jackson getting ready to run on the field for a field goal with Don Southern. However, they're not going to do that.
Well, Frank Clair thinks it's fairly safe to gamble in this situation. But it shows that it doesn't always work. Jim Mankins, who couldn't make it in Hamilton in a crucial third down gamble on Monday, is held here as well.
Take a look at this play. His lead blocker didn't get 41, Pierre Dumont. Didn't get enough of him to allow Mankins to get in there.
Jack Lentz, number 12, finally stopped him. Yeah, I don't know if Frank will ever gamble again. This has happened twice in a row now.
Frank not very happy by the look of it as he talks to that birthday. Of course, there are 45 good reasons why the fans might overlook that little mistake this time.
Marker is thrown. Riva has the ball near the 50. Gene Gaines on the tackle along with Danny Beaver for the Ottawa Rough Riders. Penalty against the Alouettes. Or against the Rough Riders has been declined by the Alouettes for illegal substitution. Now Oliva with a one-handed attempt at the 45-yard line. So it runs to second and 10 now, back at the 48 of the Montreal Elves. Trying to get something going, first with Sonny Wade and now with Carroll Williams, but little success. Thrown. Williams by Deaver. And then dropped at the 45-yard line. The holding is the indication against Ottawa, so the play will likely stand. The game was 17.
Carroll Williams thrilling the crowd with this spectacular running like we can look back to Bernie Custis type of thing. And here's number 9 running all over the field for Knott. And watch this little dance step he puts in here.
First down from the 45.
Jones, last 35, Tom.
Duncan has 5 at the 40. Basil Bark, 45, the lead blocker on the play. Speck made the tackle for the Ottawa Rough Riders. who lead 45-1 with 3:53 remaining in the third quarter. Alouettes were in scoring range only once, and on that occasion, driving to the 25-yard line, had to come away with only a single point on John Baker's wide field goal attempt. Pass thrown low at the 25-yard line for Bill Starr. It'll be third and five now from the 40. This, I believe, is only the second time today the Alouettes have been on the Rough Riders side of the 55-yard line. Tom Cassis, number 20, replacing Peter Paquette, number 26, in the Montreal huddle. And Cassis sets to the right with Lefebvre, number 10, wide left. Kara Williams has the first down on a quarterback sneak. Third and five. He got 6 yards at the 34. At the 12-minute mark of this third quarter, the score is Ottawa 45, Montreal 1.
When you were 10, one of the things you wanted to be when you grew up was a truck driver. But we wonder if you could handle the job now. Smith Transport. They handle goods between the prairies and the Atlantic and even to the U.S. It's one of the most advanced trucking operations in the world. CP Transport is our workhorse, operating from as far south as you can get to as far north as you can drive. This means wheeling mercury and steel flasks from northern B.C. Destination, New Jersey, USA. Now, how about this for a change? A radio-controlled dispatch system. Electronic motor repair centers. Computers. And this CP Express automated terminal in Toronto, one of a number we have to give us the most modern express terminals on the continent. Trucking has changed a lot since you were a kid, and so have we. Smith Transport, CP Express, CP Transport, trucking. Another way Canadian Pacific serves you.
You might not recognize the Ottawa defense. Changes like Deaver coming in for Jerry Campbell at one corner. Campbell play in the middle where Ken Lehman goes. And Wayne Smith, a defensive end for Billy Joe Booth. Doug Speck, the defensive tackle. Dennis Duncan has the pass thrown off target inside the 30. Second and 10, it'll be from the 34 and a half. 2 minutes and 50 seconds remaining in the third quarter.
You know, in a game like this, I'm sure that those 2 minutes and 50 seconds, the players would wish that was 2 minutes and 50 seconds to go in the ball game, not just the third quarter.
Far for Bob Story. And it's third and 10. The Alouettes have run more plays from scrimmage than Ottawa, but have done a lot less with them. 47 plays Montreal has attempted, and Ottawa 38. But the scoring indicates the Rough Riders have been eminently more successful. Third and 10 from just inside the 35-yard line. Tom Cassis now, number 20, coming out of the Montreal huddle. Paquette, number 26, his replacement, set to the right. Williams is down, and the ball goes over to Ottawa. Wayne Smith, Billy Joel Booth's replacement at defensive end, made the tackle back at the 38-yard line, and that's where the Riders will put the ball into play. A minute and 58 now left in the third quarter.
A lot of top action in the CFL in the next 7 days. Of course, there's that Saskatchewan-Toronto game at the CNE Stadium tomorrow afternoon. On Wednesday, Saskatchewan of Montreal. CBC television coverage of that game starting at 8 o'clock Eastern Daylight Time. along with Hamilton at Winnipeg. That also is Wednesday night.
Ben Berkley, 15 at quarterback. Marker thrown. Baker in pursuit. And Berkley gets across the line of scrimmage for about six. We'll see what the flag was all about back at the line of scrimmage.
Wood Tucker was offside there. He left a little bit too early. There must be a difference in the signal calling between Van Berkley and Jackson, or the timing. And it's obvious on a situation such as this, because the flanker is out there looking in and should not be offside.
So the penalty is 5 yards. Offside, Ottawa. They're first and 15, back at their 33. Interception by Lentz. Jim Mankins pulls him down to the 46-yard line.
I don't think that Van Berkley even saw Lentz when he threw that ball out there. He was throwing it. It looked like a pretty fair pass, and Lentz came in to intercept right in front of Vic Washington.
So the Alouettes get a chance to move the ball again from the Ottawa 46. The flag up in quarter three, and the Rough Riders in possession of a 45-1 advantage.
That's the biggest break they've had all day. They had one other interception, but it was deep in their own zone.
De La Riva. He and Ken Lehman knock heads inside the 40-yard line, but none the worse for wear on either side. It'll be second and 2.5. The Alouettes at the Ottawa 39. Cassis and Lefebvre, 20 and 10, both right. Duncan lost the ball. Poirier picked it up and steps out of the 22. 32.
Boy, some days it doesn't pay to get out of bed, does it, Bernie?
This is Ken Lehman, middle linebacker, making a great play here. He's fighting to try to get over to help in on the tackle. And just at that point is where the ball is loose, just past Ken Lehman's effort coming in.
That fumble recovery by Poirier ends play in the third quarter. And at the end of the quarter, the score is Ottawa 45, Montreal 1. We'll have more CFL action after this message.
The bold ones. Week after week, the scene will shift from the arena of law enforcement to the exciting atmosphere of an ultra-modern medical center, to the world of the courtroom and the men who bring it to life. As the law enforcers, Detective Leslie Nielsen and District Attorney Harry Rhodes.
You don't think I'd play politics at a time like this?
I think you'd pass out cigars at your father's funeral.
I happen to think you were the right man for the job.
Then into the world of new medicine, with E.G. Marshall as one of America's most distinguished surgeons. John Saxon as a pioneer in the field of heart transplants. And David Hartman, for whom the computer is a vital medical tool. Then to a trio of dynamic law partners, Burl Ives, Joseph Campanella, and James Farantino. The Bold Ones. Drama as up to the minute as a news bulletin. The Bold Ones.
For the 44-point lead, the Rough Riders now will utilize their 14th import, Darwin Garnerman, an outstanding running back who simply hasn't had